Hello and welcome to a new episode of Eliphas Leary's Lectures About Magick. I was asked to do a little video, to make a little video about what I meant in the video about the magic hand, about when I talked about using rings to program your way to interact with whatever. Well, before I get into that, something basic. The concepts we have about reality, the world view we adapt to, or that we develop ourselves, makes us blind to anything that falls outside of that world view, but at the same time it enables us to interact with special aspects of reality. You can see that in every tradition, be it a religious tradition or a magical tradition. And, well, Timothy Leary called that the reality tunnel. Your worldview is the filter that you put over yourself, and it enhances some part of reality and it blacks out other parts of reality. That's why in chaos magic, the paradigm shift, or the changing of paradigms that you're using to perceive the world, is so important. Now let me get into some examples, or one example, on maybe more than just one, on how to use rings in magic. That's bad. I have three rings that I use now for many years, and this one is a Saturnian ring. This one has a snake on it and eight skulls. This one is a blank ring made of silver. Now, the Saturnian ring, of course, is Bina, so it's the third Sephira. The one with the snake and the eight skulls, to me, represents yoga, and it represents Chochma, wisdom, the second Sephira, and the blank ring, Ketha, the first Sephira. So these three rings, to me, represent the highest triad in the Tree of Life. And that's how I use them. The fingers don't matter so much to me. To me it's more important on which hand I'm wearing these rings. So this is the normal configuration, all on one hand. And when I, for example, take the Saturnian ring, put it on the right hand, there is a kind of tension that allows a current to be activated. I have two qualities on that hand that are, well, they are what they represent to me, and I have one ring on this hand to act, to use this quality and project it on others. In that regard, or in that instance, I'm using the paradigm of the right hand being active and being the hand that sends out stuff or qualities or energy or however you want to call it. I don't like the word energy for that, but sometimes I have to use it in lack of better words. And the left hand is the hand that absorbs. So it's absorbing and sending. You'll frequently find this way to understand the polarity of the hands and the polarity of the body. So left is absorbing, right is sending out. And using symbols, for example rings that you construct as symbols, or you buy them and make them your own symbol, turn them into your own symbols, like I did with this ring, you can use these symbols as filters to stress certain qualities and eliminate other qualities, or not use other qualities, like a filter. You can do the same with other symbols. For example, this pentagram, to me it represents one thing, to others it represents other qualities. You can use a steel band on your right hand if you want to use the right hand as a symbol for Geburah or for Mars. You can use a copper band on the left hand, or even on the right hand if you want to use those qualities. The important thing is to understand that this is just something that you do yourself. It's not really a part of reality, it's something that you agree on with yourself. And if you're working in a group, you should agree with others on the meaning of symbols, not to prevent that. If someone in a ritual is doing this gesture, to prevent that someone's freaking out because he heard some conspiracy idiots that make claims about this gesture or any other gesture, and well, whatever you believe is whatever you program yourself to have as a basis for interaction with the world. I guess that's it. I hope this video was not too much from a halfway confused dude. I haven't done videos in a long while, and yesterday, depending on when you're watching this, I received a mail urging me to do this video, and here it is. I received many other mails urging me to do new videos, and I can't promise, unfortunately, to really make these videos in the next few weeks, but I'm doing my best. So that being said, as always, enjoy your life, enjoy the world, and have fun.